connect the Sonos Arc to your television, this soundbar is huge. You're gonna need at least two wires, and those one are included in the box. The first one is the power cord, which connects just right here. And the other side, of course, goes to the wall AC or a power bar. The other cable, as much important, is the HDMI. But be careful, this one cannot be connected anywhere. Of course, one of the two sides goes to the only HDMI input
of the ARC,
and the other goes to the HDMI ARC port of your TV. And when I say ARC, don't get confused, it doesn't have any link with the name of the ARC soundbar. In this case, ARC stands for Audio Return Channel. This is a technology that has been around for the last few years, and as its name says, it returns the audio from what is playing on the TV to another device like your soundbar. The connection also allows us to do some other things like audio control. The audio return channel technology works as well as an airplane without wheels. But surprisingly, unfortunately, with Sonos, it works pretty well. So among all the HDMI port there is on your television, find the one that have the indication ARC and connect the other side of your HDMI cable to this HDMI ARC port. And if you don't find one, don't worry, in the box there is an optical to HDMI adapter. So this means you can use the same HDMI cable that is connected
into your Sonos ARC
and use the other side that, instead of going to the ARC input of your TV, it goes to the adapter, and you can connect the optical cable to the optical out of your television to your soundbar. Very important, remove the cap at the end of the connector before connecting it. Otherwise, it won't work and you may break the optical output of your television if you force too much when you push the connector into it. In the last 15 years, I never seen a TV without optical output, so yours surely have one. If you didn't find it yet on your TV, it looks like this. There is a small door that shut in front of it, and you may see a red light behind it. The light you see is the audio signal. That's why it's called optical cable. And this is not the easiest cable to connect either. When you look at it, there is a side that is flat. Usually that side goes up. But as you can see on my television, it's not always the case. You have to push it until it clips. If you are part of the 0.1% of the people who doesn't have an HDMI ARC output, neither an optical output, well, you may at least have a headphone output. So if it's that your case, I'll leave you a link in the description so you can order an analog to optical converter. This means it will be your television headphone output to the converter to the optical HDMI adapter
to your ARC.
Well, it's a long way to go, but that will work. Finally, the last connector you see just right here in the middle is for the network. If you have a network outlet not too far away, I recommend you use it. Otherwise, it's not a big deal. Sonos works very well on wireless, as long as you have at least one Sonos device connected to your network with a wire. I explain all about this in details in this video. And if you want to add a sub or two or surround speakers
to your ARC,
well, you don't have the choice to have at least one device connected with a wire. It doesn't have to be one of the Sonos speaker that is in your home theater, but at least one in your house. Speaking of connection, if you want to add a sub or surround, there is nothing easier to connect. The only thing you need is the power cord. And if you need help to configure all this, I invite you to take a look at the video on the upper right corner. If your television is mounted on the wall and you want to sit your Sonos Arc right under it, well, you will need a wall mount. And I'll leave you a link in the description so you can order the original one. About the installation video, this will be for another day. Oh, and I almost forgot. I heard a lot of people complain about the fact that the Sonos Arc only have one audio input, which is the HDMI. But yet, it's largely enough. The idea is that you connect all your devices to your television. So your Apple TV, your Google Chromecast, your PlayStation, or even your cable box, dish, or DVD player, if you're one of those who still use it today. And automatically, when you select the input of that device on the television, the optical output, or the HDMI arc output, will send the audio back to your soundbar. So basically, thanks to a single wire, your Sonos Arc have as much input as your television have. So this is it. Thank you for watching. I hope it helps. If yes, please give me a thumbs up. If you want to see my other Sonos tutorial, visit my link in the description or just right here. I have a lot of video on the subject. Also, feel free to leave me a comment down below. Maybe you'll give me an idea for the next video. If you're shopping for a new Sonos device, please see my link in the description. And you should also see my video how to choose the right Sonos device for you, just right here. Finally, don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you can find me back easily next time you need help. Take care, and I hope to see you again, maybe on my main channel. See ya!